Friend, today we shall learn another poem about words from your Learning English book, page 58. This poem is written by Gertrude L. Robb. Words are little singing sounds for saying over and over again. Sometimes they look almost the same, and some of the time they rhyme. Words are wonderful things because they talk to us. Words are the most beautiful things because they spark our imagination. Let me first begin by reading out the poem for you. All of you must write down the poem in your copies. Also draw the picture. About Words by Gertrude L. Robb. Words are little singing songs for saying over and over. They run in little bootstep tracks on pages cover to cover. They make us bridges and trees and pigs and a house for a little red hen. They let us see things all over the world without even pictures of them. Sometimes they look almost the same, like children in a line. Sometimes they're not like they look at all, and some of the time they rhyme, like coat and boat and sing and swing and cones and bones and phones. Sometimes they just go splashing along like water over stones. Words can take us for long, long rides on planes or trains or the bus. Words are very wonderful things because they talk to us. So, this poem is talking about words. Words that we speak all the time. Words are something that we human beings use to communicate, to talk to one another. We use words to express our thoughts, feelings, and expressions. And while we are expressing ourselves, we humans sometimes start writing them down. Writing down, penning down our thoughts, feelings, and expressions. And these thoughts, feelings, and expressions find way sometimes onto a paper through words. And they make up pages, chapters, and even an entire library. And when we read these words, we get transferred to a whole different world, a world of imagination. These words paint pictures in front of our eyes. We start imagining every word that we read. They build bridges, paint trees and animals and houses and hills right in front of our eyes. When we read these words, they make us see things. They take us to far-off lands, to snow-capped mountains and dark forests, even without us physically not being present there. When we read words, they make us see and imagine things, even when we are not exactly seeing these places and things in reality. Sometimes the words that we read are almost the same. Here, you have learned homophones. Homophones are words that sound the same but have different meanings. Say, for example, flour, flour, and flower, flower. Flour means, flour means a powder we get after grinding grains like wheat and flour. F-L-O-W-E-R means the blossom of a plant. Another example could be S-E-E and S-E-A-C. Both you pronounce in the same way. S-E-E-C means the sense of sight, and S-E-A meaning the large salty water body that covers most of the earth. So, when the poet says, sometimes they look almost the same, this is what she means. That they are same sounding words, but they mean different. So, sometimes they look almost the same, and sometimes they're not like they look at all, which means sometimes words, they try to give us a whole new meaning altogether. And some of the time they rhyme. And sometimes if you are reading a poem that is written down with the help of a huge number of words that have been stringed together, they might even rhyme, like coat, boat, sing, swing, and cones, bones, and phones. Sometimes when these beads of words are read out and they express, and the expressions that they express are like water splashing over the stones. Words, they just flow like water over stones in a stream. Words can form their own shapes, they can go their own direction, and they can also decide their own destiny. Again, when you are reading these clusters of words that have been penned down in books, they can just take you places. They can take you for long rides, even if you may not be sitting on a plane, train, or a bus. Yet, you will find yourself carried away to a different land of storybooks. So, words are wonderful things because they are a lot more than just a mere group of letters. They let your imagination walk down a road you may or may not have known before. Words carve out a statue or shape a dream. Shapes and draws a picture in your mind every time you read it. Well, now that I have explained the poem to you, let me tell you the summary of this poem. So, please write it down. Question: write a summary for the poem about words. The small little words which we call or describe as words to express our thought, feeling, and emotions are at times quite funny and interesting. They make up pages, chapters, and books, and even an entire library. Yet, we hardly understand all of them. At times, they may describe different sounds like birds chirping or a sharp whistle, or on the other occasions, they may even describe different times and seasons like sunrise and sunset. They may even describe feelings or emotions like joy and sorrow. So, in this way, words probably define almost everything we see, feel, and experience in life, and that is what is so beautifully described in this poem. This poem tells us the importance of words. Words lead us to the world of imagination, as we may travel by train, bus, or a plane. Each word has its own story to tell. Words are not only wonderful, but also powerful tools to learn, to communicate, and to express ourselves. I'm repeating the summary again, so please listen carefully. And you will write this summary in your copies. Question: write a summary for the poem about words. The small little sounds which we call or describe as words to express our thought, feeling, and emotions are at times quite funny and interesting. They make up pages, chapters, and books, and even an entire library. Yet, we hardly understand all of them. At times, they may describe different sounds like birds chirping or a sharp whistle, or on other occasions, they may even describe different times and seasons like sunrise and sunset. They may even describe feelings or emotions like joy and sorrow. So, in this way, words probably define almost everything we see, feel, and experience in life, and that is what is so beautifully described in this poem. This poem tells us the importance of words. Words lead us to the world of imagination, as we may travel by train, bus, or a plane. Each word has its own story to tell. Words are not only wonderful, but also powerful tools to learn, to communicate, and to express ourselves. Now that I have told you the summary of this poem, we shall move on to the exercises. We shall begin with writing the meanings. I shall now give you the meanings of the different words in the poem. It is also there in your book, so I'm reading it out. You will make two different columns. One column you will write the words, and in the other column you will write the meanings, like we have always done. Number one, tracks, a series of marks left by something passing. I repeat, number one, track, meaning a series of marks left by something passing. Number two, splashing, meaning wetting by dashing masses of water. I repeat, number two, splashing, meaning wetting by dashing masses of water. Next exercise. Write out the lines from the poem which tell you, number one, where to find words. Answer: you will write in inverted commas. They run in little bootstep tracks on pages cover to cover. This indicates the books where we find the words. Always, whenever you are quoting any line from any poem, you will always write them in inverted commas. So number two, that words make us see things without pictures. Answer: in inverted commas, they let us see things all over the world without even pictures of them. Number three, that words take us for rides. Answer: in inverted commas, words can take us for long, long rides on planes, on trains, or the bus. Number four, that words move very fast. Answer: in inverted commas, sometimes they just go splashing along like water over stones. Number five, that words can produce music. In inverted commas, words are little singing sounds for saying over and over. I'm repeating from the beginning. Number one, where to find words. Answer: in inverted commas, They run in little bootstep tracks on pages cover to cover. Number two, that words make us see things without pictures. Answer, in inverted commas, they let us see things all over the world without even pictures of them. Number three, that words take us for rides. Answer, in inverted commas, words can take us for long, long rides on planes or trains or the bus. Number four, that words move very fast. Answer, in inverted commas, sometimes they just go splashing along like water over stones. And number five, that words can produce music. Answer, in inverted commas, words are little singing sounds for saying over and over. Next exercise, complete the following lines. This one you will do on your own, take help from your books and do it on your own. I'm just reading it out for you. Number one, they make us bridges. I have written half the line. You will complete this line and write the next three lines. Number two, sometimes they look. This line also I have written half the line. Complete the line and you will write the next two lines. Number three, sometimes they just here to complete the line. Write the next three lines. Number four, words are very. Complete the line. Write the next line. Number five, words are little. Complete the line. Write the next three lines. I'm explaining once again. Please follow. And please follow the chart. There too I have given the dashes in the similar manner that I am saying. So please follow correctly. Number one, they make us bridges. Complete this line. Write the next three lines. Number two, sometimes they look. Complete this line. Write the next two lines. Number three, sometimes they just. Complete this line. Write the next three lines. Number four, words are very. Complete this line and write the next line. And number five, words are little. Complete this line and write the next three lines. Now we move on to the next exercise. With the help of a dictionary, choose the correct words. So you will take the help from your dictionary and then you will find out the answers with the help of your dictionary. The meaning of these words are given in the dictionary. The first three are from your book. For those three, you require a dictionary. But the next two is from your poem. You do not require a dictionary for answering number four and number five. Only for number one, two and three, you require a dictionary. So please take the help of the dictionary. I am not telling you the answers. This exercise you shall do on your own. I'm reading it out for you. Number one, what is a pygmy? Option A, a small pig. Option B, an animal. Option C, an African tribal of short stature. Stature means height. I'm reading it out for you again. Number one, what is a pygmy? Option A, a small pig. Option B, an animal. And option C, an African tribal of short stature. Short stature means of short height. Number two, what is a Great Dane? Option A, a native of Denmark. Option B, a great man of Denmark. And option C, a breed of a very large dog. Number three, what is a porcupine? Option A, a cone. Option B, a pine cone. Option C, an animal with quills on its body. Number four, where can we find words? A, in a cupboard. B, in a chest. And C, in a book. Number five, words let us see things. A, with our imagination. B, on a television. And C, through a binocular. I'm repeating this whole exercise, so please listen. Number one, what is a pygmy? A, a small pig. B, an animal. C, an African tribal of short stature. Number two, what is a Great Dane? A, a native of Denmark. B, a great man of Denmark. C, a breed of a very large dog. Number three, what is a porcupine? A, a cone. B, a pine cone. And C, an animal with quills on its body. Number four, where can we find words? A, in a cupboard. B, in a chest. C, in books. Sorry, in a book. Number five, words let us see things. A, with our imagination. B, on a television. And C, through a binocular. Next, we shall do the question and answers. Answer the following questions. Number one, why are words... Number one, why are words wonderful things? Answer, words are wonderful things because they help us express our thoughts, feelings, and emotions. They even help us to see things all over the world in using our imagination. I repeat, words are wonderful things because they help us express our thoughts, feelings, and emotions. They even help us to see things all over the world using our imagination. Number two, which line in the poem tell you that words can produce music? Answer, the very first line of the poem, in inverted commas, words are little singing sounds for saying over and over, tells us that words can produce music. I repeat, the very first line of the poem, in inverted commas, words are little singing sounds for saying over and over, tells us that words can produce music. Number three, write down the rhyming words mentioned in the second stanza. Answer, the rhyming words mentioned in the second stanza are 1. Coat and boat, 2. Sing and swing, and number 3. Cones, bones and phones. I repeat, the rhyming words mentioned in the second stanza are 1. Coat and boat, 2. Sing and swing, 3. Cones, bones and phones. Number 4. What does the poet mean when she writes in the poem, sometimes they look almost the same like children in a line? Answer, through this line, the poet wants to tell us that some words may be same to look at or even have the same pronunciation, but they do have different meanings. I repeat, through this line, the poet wants to tell us that some words may be same to look at or even have the same pronunciation, but they do have different meanings. Number five, can words really take us on long rides on planes, trains, and buses? Answer, no. Words cannot really take us on long rides on planes, trains, and buses. But in fact, when we read words penned in books, we are transferred to far off places, like taking a long ride through our imagination. I repeat, no, words cannot really take us on long rides on planes, trains and buses. But in fact, when we read words penned in books, we are transferred to far off places, like taking a long ride through our imagination. Next exercise, answer the following questions with reference to the context. Reference, I'm reading out the reference for you. They make us bridges and trees and pigs and a house for a little red hen. Question 1. Which poem is this line taken from? Name the poet. This question has two parts. Number two, what is they referred to as here? Number three, do they actually make bridges, trees, pigs for us and a house for a little red hen? And four, what does the poet mean when she says in the poem, and some of the time they rhyme? So read the reference carefully again and then answer the question. I'm reading out the reference for you. They make us bridges and trees and pigs and a house for a little red hen. Question 1. Which poem is this line taken from? Name the poet. Answer. This line is taken from the poem About Birds. The poet is Gertrude L. Robb. Number 2. What is they referred to as here? Answer. They here is referred to words that are small little sounds we use to express our thoughts, feelings and emotions. I repeat, they here is referred to words that are small little sounds we use to express our thoughts, feelings and emotions. Next question. Do they actually make bridges, trees and pigs for us or a house for a little red hen? Answer. No. They actually do not make any bridges, trees and pigs for us, nor a house for a little red hen. It is just the power of our imagination that is triggered on reading these words. I repeat, no, they actually do not make any bridges, trees and pigs for us, nor a house for a little red hen. It is just the power of our imagination that is triggered on reading these words. Number 4. What does the poet mean when she says in the poem, and some of the time they rhyme? Answer. In the poem, when the poet says, and some of the time they rhyme, she means that when words are penned down in the form of poems, sometimes words they rhyme or make the same sound. She further goes on to give some examples to us like coat and boat, sing and swing, and cones, bones and phones. I repeat, in the poem when the poet says, and some of the time they rhyme, she means that when words are penned down in the form of poems, sometimes words they rhyme or make the same sound. She further goes on to give some examples to us like coat and boat, sing and swing, and cones, bones and phones. And with this, I end today's class. Thank you.